Okay, so let's cover some of the basics before we get onto some stock-specific questions. It's a dollar-based portfolio?
Yes.
Okay, we also, I think there's talk that you've launched a Rand-based feeder in that regard, is that correct?
Yes, so in April we launched our ZAR feeder fund, which basically just feeds into the USD fund, and it just gives our investors the opportunity to invest in Rands.
And I would imagine no liquidity issues with the names here. It's daily traded, correct?
Yes, no liquidity at all.
All righty. So if I look through this, you also geographically nicely spread. As you would imagine, 50% out of the US, but then a smattering across the rest of the world. But I would also think that your revenue lines out of these names, if I'm looking at some of these names, are also diverse. These are not companies that derive revenue out of one single country. Is that also something you look at?
Yes, so definitely. I think what's nice about global investing is that, yes, a lot of the mega cap stocks are listed on in developed markets, but basically they do have very diverse revenue bases. So Unilever, for instance, has about 60% of their revenue coming from emerging markets, which is very attractive to us. Not only because if we feel emerging markets is a great place to be, we can tilt the portfolio by investing in a stock like this, but also these companies are in hundreds of countries. So if something goes wrong in one of those specific countries,
it won't necessarily beat
exactly,
the stock
it's
up.
It's not going to be the end of the world. Sure. So we really like good geographic diversification, but also in the same respect, we want our portfolio at certain times to be tilted towards EM markets and then certain times towards developed markets.
And you can tilt at that as depending on your house view.
Because of the type of stocks we can invest in.
So it's interesting because we talk about diversification. There was a terminology in our industry a while ago called diversification because you could buy an equity portfolio with 100 stocks. That's clearly not this mandate. So you mentioned 20 to 30, currently around 20 stocks. Do you foresee ever getting to 30 stocks or would gravitate around the 20 to 25 stocks?
I think 20 to 25 is mostly where
you want to play.